Okay, guys, so here are my leopard geckos. This is Liberty. She was my first little mama. She is a Max Snow. I got her at a reptile show here in Knoxville. She gave us some really good eggs last year, and she's got some more on the way this year. And this right here is my newest little gecko. This is a bandit. This is Garland, who I hope to be able to pair with Blitzen next season to give us some bold bandits. So if you are into the bandits, please stay tuned next season for some really beautiful bold bandit babies, hopefully, from her and Blitzen. If you've seen any of our, any of our channels, then you've probably seen one with Blitzen in it, and you know how friendly he is. So hopefully they're going to be boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, you know, something next season. I'm going to put her back.
And she's got such a great personality already.
Blitzen's already wanting out.
He's our socialite.
He loves to come out. Hey, bud. I know. Come on.
Blitzen was originally mine, and Jennifer stole him.
He's okay. Come on.
This is my favorite leopard gecko.
So, he has a great personality. Sometimes he just likes to chill on my neck underneath my hair. And he has done that for about 2 hours before at a time. And then I'll put him back. But hopefully next year, him and little Garland will give us some really pretty bandit babies. So that's Blitzen. He's probably our most famous gecko that we have just because he is the more outgoing personality. This one is Mitten. She's fairly new to me as well. I got her from Morph Market. And I'm sorry, I don't recall where exactly I got her from. I'd have to go back and look. I don't want to pick her up and get her out. She's still a little timid, but she is a super snow. She's beautiful. I named her Mitten because her right front leg is white, like she has on a mitten. I don't know if you can get that from her.
Yeah, she's hiding it from us.
Yeah, I don't want to stress her out too bad. Hey, come here.
Well, you get the idea. Maybe that'll... There we go. That's focused. She's got a mitten on.
Then I've got Snowbell. So this is my favorite gecko because she's the bold, black and white, super snow, and she's being very weird right now.
It's breeding season, so yeah. They're all on edge.
Now, she has given us some eggs this season as well as last season. She will normally just let me reach in and grab her and pick her up, but she's kind of doing something finicky with her tail right now, so I don't really want to get her either. I'm not one of those people that will stress a gecko out. I don't like doing that. If they want to be picked up, they'll let me pick them up without, you know, the tail thing and all that. So she's used to being picked up, but I don't want to stress her out. And I don't want to stress this one out either. So let's just kind of, until I can get her back where she needs to go, let's just do that. Did you get her?
I did.
Okay. Uh-huh. So this season, he is new to us. I've had him for a while, but he's new this season. I paired Snowbell to Prancer. Prancer is my super snow eclipse. Come here, bud. Will you let me pick you up? Come here.
Nobody wants to be picked up over here. Come here. Okay. He's rattling his tail, so I'm not going to pick him up either.
Yeah, the animals come first before the videos.
So he does not have quite as bold black. Look, I think they can smell each other or something. I should just put them together. He does not have quite as bold black markings as Snowbell does, but he is an eclipse. So, and then, so this is pretty cool. We never gave them an official name. They're just 3 and 4 because they were babies 3 and 4 from our first babies last season. 3 is actually from Blitzen and Snowbell from last year. And she thinks it's feeding time, so there she is. And she became a little mama this year. She gave us, our little babies that we'll show you in just a minute. And she thinks my fingernail is food, so yeah. I can't hardly do black polish on my nails because they really do like bite at my fingers. And this is 4. She is a product of Blitzen and Liberty, the first one I showed you from last season. And they all just have such great personalities.
Yeah, anytime we open this tub, she's sitting there smiling at us.
And then this little guy, this is Kyber. He's kind of our little rescue that we took in. We got him from a friend of ours who, come here, Kyber. He don't even want to be picked up. And he's always, come here.
He was in very sad shape when our friend got him.
So, whoever had him prior did not take proper care of him and did not give him the proper moistness that he needed to shed. So, he lost some of his poor little toes and he has no claws whatsoever. He has no way of gripping or holding on to anything. So when I pick him up, I'm really careful. He can't really climb up my arm like the rest of them can. Can you zoom in on his little foot?
I can, yes ma'am.
Yeah. So he's our little rescue. And then this is Mistletoe.
Storm back up.
And she, I'm not picking her up right now. She, in the past, has let me pick her up. But she is very food-driven and very into breeding season. And
hey, babe.
I don't even put her food in her bowl anymore. I feed her directly from my tongs, and she takes it very aggressively. So she's looking at me because she knows I give her the food. So she is waiting for me to feed her right now. Straight at me. I don't have your food. I'm sorry. It's just my hand. I'm so sorry. And then our 2 babies that have hatched so far this season, we have eggs in the incubator right here. But the ones that we have so far, and they're healthy, they're thriving, they're doing great. You've probably seen some videos up already of them if you've been following along. They're from number 3 in Prancer, but I'm just gonna go ahead and show them again, just cause we're here. But let's see, oh, there's some poop on the lid right there.
We love seeing poop from babies. And those lids are not easy to get off.
No, they're not. So this is the first one. These are they turned out to be Super Snows. She just has beautiful markings. And I'm really trying to be careful because I don't want her popping out. There go the dogs.
That means somebody is walking by, probably with another dog.
And then this is baby number two. And so far, she looks like she's going to be an eclipse. And she just shed today. She is freshly shed.
And these already have wonderful little personalities. Wow, she's looking good. We're not sure which of these will be our keeper. We're going to wait and see how they color out. And then I showed the eggs in a previous video, maybe yesterday, so we don't have to do that.
He's making a fuss down here. Let me get him settled. But that's it. That's all my geckos for now until more babies hatch out. I never push them. I never stress them out. They want to be held, of course, they do. But, you know, the ones, especially Mitten, I think she's probably the one right now that just does not want anything to do with me or anybody. In fact, I've had her probably over a month, about a month, month and a half now, maybe. And until last night, she hasn't even eaten for me. But I haven't been too concerned because, as you can tell, she is not starving. Her tail is a good size. So, you know, they store food in their tail, the fat. So I wasn't too concerned, but, you know, it always makes you feel good to, for one of them to eat for you, especially when you just get them. So last night was a huge success moment for me. I felt so much better. I was very excited. So anyways, that's a little bit about my animals. So now let's take a look at some snakes.